At tomorrow's National Anzac Day ceremony, the Governor-General won't just be waving at the troops as they pass by. He'll be where he was 30 years ago, leading them at the head of the march. Hugh Rimmington sat down with David Hurley as he reflected on one of the Army's lesser-known deployments, a peacekeeping mission to Somalia, and the importance of being reunited with those troops three decades later.
What were the conditions that the Australians confronted on the ground?
So when we arrived, there were still every morning and newly deceased people's bodies laid out in the streets. Nowhere to put them, nowhere to bury them, frankly. And no civil society, no government structure.
Do you think that it was confronting for young Australian soldiers to find themselves in an environment that was so unfamiliar to them?
Oh, very much so. Most of our training concentrated on our region, either looking north or east as to where we might do a variety of operations. But you know, Africa was not on our radar, and then culturally, therefore, we weren't even thinking about what we might do if we ever went to Africa. Coming out of sunny Townsville, all prepared for Christmas leave, and finding yourself within a week confronting people on death's door. And, you know, some of the images are just shocking.
You have the unique position, I understand it's historically without precedent, of being a Governor-General who will not be on the viewing stand for a period at the Anzac Day National March. You'll be down there leading the march. What will be your thoughts at that moment? What's your sense of pride of the people who, the Somali veterans, who will have the honour this year of leading the march?
No, I'll be very, very proud to be, you know, be able to march with them again on an occasion like that. I've got to do a bit of ballet to move off the parade and to be in the saluting point when they come past. I hope for them, and it will be, as for me, a very memorable occasion to be proud of what we achieved, to thank everybody, to reconnect, and make sure we're looking after each other. All those things that gatherings like this serve to do.
And we'll have more of that exclusive interview with the Governor-General David Hurley in our special Anzac Day Dawn special coverage tomorrow, right here on 10 tomorrow at 4:20.